Welcome to 8-Minute Automation. Today I'm going to show you the table operations. Inside the table operation, we are using the FIFO and the LIFO. You can see the extension instruction right here. Inside the table operations or the table functions, we can see the FIFO and the LIFO function blocks. So let's discuss about the, both of the blocks are powered by two memory bits. That will be M0.0 and M0.2. And you can see the values inside the table. The FIFO needs a table. The FIFO stands for first in, first out. The first feedback value should be exit on the first triggering. You can see the return value will be MW100 for the FIFO and MW102 for the LIFO. The table will be, or the starting address of the table should be common for both of the FIFO and LIFO. So MW0, from MW0 the FIFO table is going to be started. So let's go to the help of the FIFO first. So I'm selecting the FIFO block and strike my F1 in my keyboard. So I'll be getting the corresponding help for the FIFO. So by getting this FIFO help, we can go to discuss the terms. So I'm snipping this thing. So you can see before processing, this will be the table. The first element or the starting address stands for the length of the table, that is mentioned as 6. So that contains 6 elements. So the MW50 in our condition will be, or in our data will be considered as 6, or the number of elements. Okay. And the second thing, that will be they are using word 10, after that they are using word 12. So we have to use, instead of word 12, we have to use the memory word 52. Inside the 52, we have to mention how many elements are present, or how many that has to be fed to the table, or how many entries are there inside the FIFO table. That will be they are using in the example as 5. They have to use a 4 or something else. And you can see the 5 elements will be present: 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Up to 5 it is present. After this value, that will be everyone will be 0. And the first, before processing, you can see the return value will be 0. And we can go for after processing section. You can see the length of the table should be common, and you can see while processing or while triggering, that will be reduced by 1, and the number of elements should be 4, because while processing, first element should be exit. You can see the first element, it is 12. 12 has been exited and feed to the return value. Okay, while feeding the return value, the just below the value or the just before the value, it is 29. 29 will be popping up right here. 29, the value 29 will be popping it to the second position, and 90 will be popping to the third position, like that. So on each and every trigger, that will be popping up. And we can go for the FIFO section, we can go for the runtime. So I'm starting my simulation, or have to download this process. First I am going to show you the FIFO. So I just want to enter the values. I'm going to the run mode, and the values are starting from, oh, the table is starting from MW50. We have to enter the values in the MW50. We have to use 4 elements. Okay, the 4 elements, and the number of elements should be considered, or the total number of elements should be 4. Okay, this is the first element. The number of elements will be 4. And those 4 elements should be entered here in the MW50, 52, and from 54 to 60, you have to enter the 4 elements. So I'm using 1, 2, 3, and 4. I just entered 4 elements, and this is the total number of elements present inside the table, and this is the total length of the table. And I can give the length of the table as 5 or ending. So that's it. And I'm going to show you by triggering the M0.0, that will be triggering the FIFO table. So I'm triggering the M0.0. By triggering this, this will be the value or the return value, that will be MW100. You can see the first in will be first out. You can see there is no 1. I just entered 1 here, and 1 has been popped up to the output. And when I'm pressing again, you can see the 2 will be popped up. During this time, the last value will be popping to the outside. You can see the last value 4 pop up to the next one, like that. 2, 3, and the last one, it is 4. That is the FIFO. So let's go and watch the LIFO. So just entering the values as, again, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, these are my values. And I'm going to give the current values of 4. By triggering the LIFO, you can trigger the M0.2 right here. By triggering the LIFO, you can see the values up to MW1 or 2. I will show you. The first value is popped up to 4. Next, again triggering, it is 3. The last in, first out. The last fitted value will be gets an output by the first value. That is the first in, first out, and last in, first out in the FIFO table, FIFO and LIFO table inside the TIA portal. So hope you enjoyed. If you have any doubts, you can comment down below. Thank you.